children. Now we will study the importance of this atmosphere, and we know that the balance between this living world is sustained only because of the constituents of air, their proportion and all these things. Also, this atmosphere, it is very, very important sphere of the earth, because it acts as the important filter. How it acts as a filter? Because it protects the living things by giving us the sunlight and heat of the sun. It allows only the heat of the sun to reach the earth, the sunlight to reach the earth, and in this way it gives us the very important factors, sunlight and heat of the sun, and that's why this atmosphere is very important. Also, very important factors: clouds, rain, fog, mist, snow, all these are formed in the layer of atmosphere. We have studied the five layers of the atmosphere also. Which are these layers? Yes, we have seen one sentence for that. Tusse mila Indian ek bar. T for troposphere. S for stratosphere. M for mesosphere. I for ionosphere. Ionosphere is also called thermosphere and exosphere. Now, today we are going to study very important layer, ozone layer, that is present in this atmosphere. And this ozone layer is present in the lower part of stratosphere. See, troposphere is near the earth. It is the first layer of the atmosphere. It constitutes near about 80% of gases in the air. Then next to troposphere there is stratosphere, and this stratosphere comprises 19% of gases in the air. And in this stratosphere, very important ozone layer is present. Ozone, the molecular formula of ozone is O3. This is O3. And this ozone layer is present in the lower part of stratosphere. This gas, it absorbs the harmful ultraviolet rays coming from the sun. We know from sun we get sunlight, heat, but it also contains harmful ultraviolet rays. And when these rays come towards the earth, these rays are reflected back by the ozone layer that is present in stratosphere. It reflects back the ultraviolet rays, and in this way it protects us. It protects the living things from the harmful effects of these UV rays. UV rays means ultraviolet rays. And that's why it acts as the protective umbrella. It acts as protective umbrella. It is the ozone umbrella. And that's why it is called protective shield or protective umbrella. Now, nowadays, we are becoming ungrateful to the nature because of increasing population, because of increase in traffic, vehicles, as well as we are using so many inventions of science like refrigerator, air conditioner, fire extinguishers, and these are becoming harmful to us. We need refrigerator in our day-to-day life, everyday life. Also, we need AC for so many times, and these are very harmful. How they are harmful? Because the harmful gases are coming out from these: carbon tetrachloride, tetra. Tetra means four. Carbon tetrachloride, it contains four atoms of chlorine. That's why the molecular formula of carbon tetrachloride is CCl4. Carbon tetrachloride, CCl4. See, tetra is the prefix that is used for four. And that's why CCl4 is the molecular formula of carbon tetrachloride. Then chlorofluorocarbon, chlorofluorocarbon. It is also very harmful gas, and CFC, it is also called CFC. You know, these two gases, they are causing the depletion of ozone layer. There are holes in ozone layer because of global warming, because of all these things, increase in the use of refrigerator, ACs, fire extinguishers. Because of all these things, we are responsible for the depletion of very important layer, ozone layer. Though this ozone layer, it does not play direct role in our survival, but it is indirectly very, very important for us. That's why it is our duty to protect, to maintain the ozone layer. And we for that, what should we do? We should increase the awareness of using good quality and new refrigerators. If the refrigerators are old, near about 20 years old, we should dispose them. We should not use them. We should take new refrigerators so that it cannot emit so much amount of these harmful gases. And we should make sure that our AC, our refrigerator should not emit these gases. And we should also try to make, try to do the cooperation to the governmental schemes so that we should not be responsible for global warming. We should try to maintain the ecological balance also. If we avoid all these things, what will happen? We will be responsible for depletion of ozone layer, and this will cause the skin problems, skin diseases, because it will harm these gases, these ultraviolet rays, they will reach to us directly because there will be no barrier of ozone layer, no absorption of all these ultraviolet rays, and they will reach to earth and they will cause skin diseases, they will cause cancers. And in this way, they will cause harm to us, these ultraviolet rays. That's why ozone layer is very, very important for us. And the whole world has understood the importance of ozone layer, and that's why Ozone Protection Day is celebrated throughout the world. Ozone Protection Day. And when it is celebrated? For the awareness of it, it is celebrated on 16th of September throughout the world. So, when do we celebrate Ozone Protection Day? On 16th September. Have you understood? Ozone layer and